people out in one round, but then I just started getting fat. And that's just the way it goes. I'm sorry. But I can still go 15 rounds with anybody out there in America. So let's get it on. That's what? My friend Judge Mills would say.
Judge Mills, is he the guy? Let me tell you something, Mike Tyson.
Mm-hmm.
When you have a box lunch at work,
yeah.
Is Evander Holyfield's ear in there?
Oh, no. That was alleged. That was alleged. Now, I did not bite any man's ear. You did not see that. No. If you watch the videotape, I only just simply gave him a little love tap.
Well, let me tell you something. I'm very skinny myself. I don't eat any carbs. And someone told me I should bite more ears off. So I don't know. There's no carbs in that. So maybe this man might be ahead of his time. Who knows?
Yeah.
Who knows?
I am.
Also, there's a movie about you, Mike Tyson, and I'm looking forward to see it. In fact, I'm looking forward to missing it.
Oh, that's not nice, Larry. Yeah. I'm the world champion.
All right. And let me tell you, well, I guess I can't really speak myself, all the wives I've had, you know. I've been married so many times that my wedding license is on Xerox paper. But let me tell you, all three of us, we've had the worst times with girls and with women and everything. I think Brad Pitt is on the line. He's sending us a thank you note.
All right. I'll beat him up too. Bring him onto the ring. Come on, Brad.
All right.
Come on.
Hi, we have, let's see who else is here. We have foot covering, Susan Socks, line two. There we go. Who is she? Answer the phone.
Yeah. You still doing a whole lot of horns?
Yes, all the time.
I said Brianna. Is she still horn?
Brianna.
Brianna.
Well, you can respond to it now.
You know, what I do in my personal life is my business. You know, if you would like to call me sometime, if you need some needs in your life, you know, you can do so, if you go to my website. But, you know, whoring is really not the word for it. I get paid for what I do, and, you know, what I do is very simple. It doesn't really take my body at all, so I don't know what you're talking about in those regards. Sorry.
Whoa. That's amazing.
I know. These guys think they have such license when they call. I mean, let me tell you about men today. It's 98% of them to give that 2% a bad name.
Oh.
Wow. Chris, you know all about that.
Crazy.
Chris knows all about that.
You know what's really sad is that, she's less afraid of Mike Tyson than being anywhere near you.
Yeah.
Woof.
Now, what can you be talking about?
Like, he can teach you chivalry. Mike Tyson can teach this man chivalry.
You're right. I could. I could teach you how to be a gentleman.
And you have room to talk over there.
What?
You have room to talk over there.
What do you mean? I am a gentleman. I mean, I give everybody the perfect utmost respect for women.
Oh, really?
Yes, I do, Chris Brown.
Well, let's talk about what happened in the 90s, like 1992. What happened to Desiree or whatever?
I don't remember her last name either, but I know what you're talking about. You know, that was just simply speculation and rumor.
I think you've been listening to too many Neil Diamond albums. You know what he says. This man actually served time in the Who's Gal.
That's right.
What did
I,
you
I
do?
Sure
you pick up garbage in Richmond. I never see any garbage in Richmond. I've been here. I see waste paper in the basket, and that's all I see. I don't see any coffee grounds or fish heads or what constitutes the garbage everywhere else. Like
that's right.
you have it made. You have it easy, Mr. Brown.
No, like I take responsibility for everything that's happened and do whatever I have to do. And like I said, picking up garbage, if that's what it takes, so be it.
What?
And, you know, like I said, I know, you know people be talking about celebrities, they be getting off. I don't like to think like that. Because like I said, as a man, you know, I have to take responsibility for my actions.
I know what it means.
And how are you doing that besides the garbage? I mean, in your personal life.
Again, I'm going to be going through counseling, taking anger management classes. Again, like I said, consult with, you know, everybody as possible. Try to get my mind and myself straight.
Wow.
Dick Gesinwell from Detroit, Michigan. Yes.
Hello.
Hello. You're on the Larry King Show.
Hey, how y'all doing today?
Howdy. Well, do you have a question for Mike Tyson or Rihanna or Chris Brown or whoever else may come in this revolving door of people?
I like I like to speak to the young lady.
Well, you have a question for Rihanna. What do you have to say?
How you doing?
Hello?
Yeah.
I like to speak to the young lady on there.
You can speak to me. I'm here.
Oh, what's good with you, little mom?
You know, living life, making records.
Huh?
Making records, living life. You know, I just got over this situation with Chris Brown, so right now I'm just laying low. Are you starstruck?
Okay, yeah. Okay, that's what's up, but I just want to say you look nice, and,
What do you have in your hand? What do you have in your hand right now?
Yeah, you need to get on.
What do you have in your hand right now?
Put both hands on the table.
What I got on my hands?
Yeah. What are you doing?
I think we know what type of phone call this is. I am shocked. I am shocked and appalled by this. I am shocked and appalled by this behavior by our viewers. Wow. This is the filthiest place I've ever been to. Someone find me my pants and I'll walk out of here.
Wow.
Oh, wait, my suspenders are tucked too. It works out fine.
Wow.
Anyway, all right. All right, now, I know guys like you. Let me get back. I haven't finished yelling at you. Where was I? Anyway, I know guys like you. You think you could just waltz in and with your music and your fancy clothes and your handsome haircut and your beautiful modern day spectacles, and you think you could just take any woman that you want. It's hard work, and you'd make it so easy.
That's not true.
You're right. It's not true. It's very hard to do this. It's very hard to. You know what it's like to be married 8 times.
Wow.
Hi. How many times have you been married?
Wait a minute. Too many to count.
And now, how many times have you been married?
I've never been married.
Never been married.
Wow. You don't know what you're in for.
Never been married, huh?
And also, you think you could just waltz in to Richmond, Virginia? This wonderful place with the Monument Avenue and a Starbucks and McDonald's on every corner, and you think you could just take this town over with your garbage? What? Now, are you going to record? I mean, do you have a song or a poem you could sing for us tonight to make it all right?
Well, I'm in the middle of in the studio right now, about to make a song, an apology song. It'll be out next week.
All right.
Oh, this is the first time I hear this. Can you sing us a little bit of it?
Well, I would right now, but unfortunately, you know, it's a secret. I want to give it to all my fans at the same time.
All your fans, both of his fans, both of his fans that he still has left, his mom and his dad.
Wow. Now, do you have a song you could sing for us?
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, actually, I don't. Never mind.
Oh, come on.
I can't release it.
I got a song I can sing. Roses are red, violets are blue. Chris and Rihanna, you're all through.
Oh.
And you're watching Larry King Show.
That's right. Quietly with others. In fact, when the series first debuted, the only regular was Richard Dawson. So, without further ado, let's take a look at the very first episode of the season that started it all in 1974. All right.
That camera work was the best camera. All right. We welcome you, ladies. Pleasure to have you here. And we want to find out a little bit about you. And we especially want to find out about you, Stanley. How did that happen?
Hey, George, my mother went to the movies a lot. George, I thought you were going to she
saw Betty Davis. That's not what you think. Well, tell us about it.
She saw Betty Davis starring as a girl named Stanley. And in this honor.
You're just showing the clip.
And she decided that was it.
And that was your name.
Right.
And are you from this area?
Yes, I'm a native Californian. I live in Los Angeles.
Okay, nice to have you with us. And how about you? Joan Roselle, tell us a little about yourself.
All right, I have two handsome sons. I work part-time in public relations, and I love music and sports.
Okay, good luck to you, ladies. Here we go. Both of you are going to try to match our six celebrities in answering questions. You're going to get two chances. At the end of the second round, whoever's matched the most celebrities wins, gets $100, and has the right to go to our super match where you can win over $5,000. So everybody get set, and we're going to start that game right after this. Okay, here we go with match game 73. Is everybody ready for round one?
Yes.
All right, here we go with round one. There it is. Now, Joan, since this is the very first show, you won the toss backstage, so you will make the selections, and there they are.
Okay, B.
B is what she picks. Everyone plays. Listen carefully. The sexiest thing a woman can wear is blank. Did you hear that, Joan? The sexiest thing a woman can wear is blank. Who is that in the audience saying, ooh, watch that out there. All right, everyone ready over here. You're not quite ready. Okay, now you are ready. Now let's get Joan Roselle's response. What do you say the sexiest thing a woman can wear is?
I'll say a negligee.
A negligee?
Yes.
Okay, that's what she says. Let's see if she scores with that. Mike Landon?
Well, I saw one of my wife's baby pictures. And I said, just herself.
So, in effect, that would be nothing. But yes. That's very interesting. No match there, though. Vicky.
I tend to agree with Joan. However, I put this. I don't know why.
Nothing.
Which is probably more a man's opinion than it is a woman's, I guess.
Okay, so we're looking for a negligee, Jack. What have you got?
And with the exclusion of my wife. Nothing.
All right, we're looking for a negligee. Joanne, what do you say?
Well, I think you should keep them guessing, and I always think if you're really covered up, it's much more than a bother. So I said a long dress.
A long dress. Exactly what you're wearing, and you ain't doing bad in that, honey. Joanne, Richard, what do you say?
Do you have any nude pictures of yourself? Would you like to buy some? I love Marilyn Monroe, and that's what she said.
Look at this.
Perfume.
So we haven't got a negligee so far. Let's see if we get one from Sweetie or Anita.
Tell the truth, I really couldn't spell negligee, and then I think I look best in nothing.
Okay.
Racy, right from the top, you gotta love it. Now that Jack Klugman was a funny guy, wasn't he? I know, I sure thought so, and I was the wife. That's right. It's day one, and I'm not even on the show yet, and already it's open season on Brett. Now, here's an interesting little tidbit of trivia that might interest you. I got my big break to be on Match Game due to the fact that my mean old husband at the time simply wouldn't shut up about me, meaning I was the butt of Jack's every joke on those first few episodes.
In a way, she's right. Squeeze a girl, squeeze my wife, or you squeeze a lemon. It all comes.
Well, I think it's certainly a portion thereof. Her wrinkles.
Her wrinkles. Can't match that. And how about you, Vicki Lawrence?
I'd have to agree with Michael. Do we win any money? Wrinkles.
Okay, Jack?
These people must spend a lot of time with my wife. Wrinkles.
Wrinkles. And I thank you for being here. Listen,
what
Jack.
What is that borderly got over there?
This,
what is that lace?
That's real it's not lace. It's just a little fancy stitching because it's a fancy show.
Uh-huh.
Now, you've been putting Brett down on some of your previous answers here. And why do you... She's a lovely lady. Why do you do that?
She's a lovely... How well do you know her? I have lived with her for 20 years. I put her down. She's a lovely lady.
She's a lovely lady.
We have to pay the rent, so I put her down.
Oh, I see. That's all an act. All right.
I'm afraid to do that. I mean, I like to be able to do it, but we can't.
A likely story. Lucky for me, I had an unexpected ally in the form of the incredibly talented Gene Rayburn.
One is,
within a matter of days, he invited me to appear on the 11th episode, which would also mark the very first time Charles and I ever appeared on the show together. Though notice that we are not yet in our usual seats. As he introduced me,
whenever you're ready.
Gene gave me a lovely introduction and explained
all. 2, 4, 6.
Let's see how my opening night went.